Belinda Audio presents this unabridged recording of Netball Mission, written by Bernadette Hellard and Lisa Gibbs, and read by Jayne Tuttle. Chapter 1. Rachel leapt for the high pass from Sophie, then felt a sudden loss of tension around her waist and the disconcerting coolness of the afternoon breeze against her upper thighs. "Oh my God, please tell me I'm wrong," she silently begged. "If my skirt falls off, I'll die." Desperately, she dropped one hand to grab at whatever material she could find and clamped her knees together to try to stop her skirt mid-slide. Even though she was twisted in contortions trying to save it, Rachel still managed to mark the ball with one hand before landing awkwardly. She looked down in despair at where her skirt should have been and was horrified to see that instead of the wraparound skirt, her flushed, blotchy thighs were on display for all to see. Her hand had caught her sweaty white top in a scrunch around her waist, which didn't cover the old black sports briefs that were creeping up between her bum cheeks. The traitorous navy skirt fanned out on the ground around her feet. All the players and spectators turned to see what had stopped the flow of play on the netball court. The boys on the sidelines immediately hooted and whistled in delight. Rachel began to reach down to the ground for her skirt, mortified, when she realised that all the girls on court had relaxed for a moment. They were laughing good-naturedly at Rachel's mishap and unconsciously checking their own skirts to make sure they were secure. Seeing that the opposition was distracted, Rachel abandoned her skirt and went for the long pass to Stephanie, who was standing just outside the goal circle. Rachel raced down the court to take the pass back from Steph and then fed it to the goaler right under the goal ring. Once the goal was safely through, Rachel trotted back to her skirt and quickly wrapped it around her waist. Keeping her eye on her player, Rachel prepared to defend the next centre pass. She didn't dare to look at her new boyfriend Daniel and his mates on the sideline. Her cheeks were still red with embarrassment, and she couldn't imagine what she was going to say to them when the final siren went. "Boop!" "Oh, damn, there it goes already," Rachel muttered. Sophie ran over to Rachel as they walked off the court. "That was so cool the way you played on. I would have died." "I was dying," exclaimed Rachel, her hands holding her burning face. "Well, don't worry about it," Sophie reassured her. "Nobody would have ever guessed by the way you kept playing." Rachel smiled at her best friend with gratitude and brightened even more when she saw who had come to watch the game. "Look, Soph, it's my cousin Cassie, the one I was telling you about. Hi, Cass," Rachel called out to the petite girl with long blonde curls, which were barely kept under control by a white and black stretch headband, who came bouncing over. "Hi, Rach. I came down for some entertainment and boy did I get it," she teased. "I can't believe you kept playing in your undies." Rachel shrugged her shoulders, annoyed that Cassie was making her feel stupid. "Well, I couldn't put the ball down," she retorted. "The other team would have got it." "That's right, Rachel," the girls' coach Michaela bellowed approvingly as she headed over to the cluster of Penley players. "We have to maintain focus at all costs if we are going to be a winning team. They won't all be as easy as today's game." Rachel smiled appreciatively, then looked away, hoping that everyone would change the topic. She had just started playing with the Penley 15 and under A side this season. She had switched clubs so that she could play with Sophie. The girls were much nicer on this team, but she still didn't know them well enough to feel comfortable about this kind of incident. She realised that Daniel was waiting nearby, standing astride his bike and leaning on the handlebars. "Good game," he smiled, then added sternly, "Good focus," while frowning in a poor imitation of Michaela. Rachel laughed and wondered how she could ever have worried that he would make her feel silly. As Rachel, Sophie and two other players, Steph and Melissa, began to collect their things and drift back over towards Daniel and his mates, Cassie stayed close. Are these guys normally here? She asked breathlessly. Sophie glanced at her impatiently, but answered politely, No, they're usually playing football, but they had a bye today. Cassie nodded and pranced ahead of the girls in her low-slung pants and long-sleeved white crop top. She was giggling at nothing in particular and kept raising her arms to flick her hair back over her shoulder, revealing a pierced navel ring as she did it. Each time she looked over at the boys, who were doing figure eights down the court on their bikes, to see if they noticed. Rachel introduced Cassie to Sophie, Daniel, and other friends standing around. Some of the boys rode their bikes over to see who the new girl was, and Cassie giggled nervously. So what are you guys doing tonight? Cassie piped up when she noticed that Rachel and Sophie were getting ready to leave. I'm staying at Sophie's tonight, Rachel explained. She turned to Daniel. Did you get a video or will we get one on the way home? Cassie's eyes widened with excitement. Is everyone going to be there? What time's it starting? Rachel looked at Cassie with confusion. What do you mean? Daniel lives there. He's Sophie's brother. Cassie's jaw dropped. You're kidding, she gushed. That's great. It's like an instant party every time you visit. Is it all right if I stay over too? I could go home, get my gear, and come straight around. Sophie was so shocked at Cassie's cheek that she just looked helplessly at Rachel. Cassie, Rachel said uncertainly, I'm staying at Sophie's because we've got a netball regional screening day tomorrow and Sophie's dad is taking us there. That's okay, I don't mind, Cassie said brightly. Now, what video are we going to get? Rachel glanced at Sophie with a silent apology, then shrugged and muttered, I don't know. It looked as though their planned quiet evening had been hijacked by, desperate for excitement, Cassie. Rachel and Sophie had a big day tomorrow. The regional screening day was a netball selection day. If they were chosen, they would have the opportunity to attend a zone talent camp. Here, all the best players in the zone would be coached, observed, and their netball skills assessed for potential selection for a zone talent squad. Both girls desperately wanted to do well. They wanted to play netball for Australia one day and worked towards it constantly, developing their game and incorporating extra training sessions into their week. They fully understood the importance of this screening day. It was one step towards achieving their dream. If they didn't impress the selectors tomorrow, that could be it. At 15, their chance to play elite netball could be gone. They knew they needed to be fresh and alert, so they'd planned a quiet night with a video, then early to bed and early to rise the next morning. Daniel was happy to go along with their plans. His mate Ben would be there, and he'd spend the evening cuddled on the couch with Rachel. Chapter 2. Having left the rest of the group at the netball courts, Rachel, Sophie, Daniel, Ben and Cassie headed for the video store. Rachel noticed that Cassie was acting differently. She giggled annoyingly every time one of the guys spoke and tossed her hair as she bounced down the street. When they reached the store, they roamed up and down the aisles, scanning the video covers lined up along the shelves. Every few seconds, Cassie squealed with breathless excitement over one, or pretended to be embarrassed by an R-rated video. Sophie sidled up next to Rachel and murmured in her ear, What drugs is that girl on? Rachel grinned over her shoulder at her friend. Who knows, she answered. Maybe she has, I'm in the company of boys fever. She doesn't normally act this stupid. She's usually good value. They're not boys, Sophie joked. They're just Daniel and Ben. Oh no, please don't make us, Daniel and Ben pleaded and groaned in exaggerated despair. They made desperate attempts to stop the girls moving towards the counter. It'll be terrible. Anything but that. Stop whining. It will be a great video, Sophie promised cheerfully. I'll make you a deal. If we can get looking for Alibrandi, I'll make a huge bowl of popcorn dripping with butter, just the way you like it. Rachel and Sophie gave the boys huge, cheesy smiles as they pushed them away from the shop counter. Cassie attempted to look stern and placed herself in front of the boys. It's 3 against 2. Bad luck, guys. Besides, Rachel added, it's our turn to choose. You made us sit through that action thingy last time. Daniel moved to stand behind Rachel. He wrapped his arms around her waist as they waited to collect the video. For your information, Scout, he said, bending down to nuzzle her neck. It was not an action thingy. It was Gladiator, a historical movie. Yeah, sure, Rachel ribbed him. And stop calling me Scout. Scout was the nickname Daniel had given Rachel. He had teased her about being a failed scout the first time she'd come to their house and he found her lost outside the front gate. Rachel pretended the nickname annoyed her, but secretly she enjoyed his special name for her. They made their way through the suburban streets to the Mitchells' house, complaining about each other's taste in videos. The late afternoon sun had lost its warmth and a cold wind blew through the trees lining the street. A hot shower and warm clothes would be a welcome end to the day. The girls had long since cooled down after their usual Saturday afternoon club game, and now they felt chilled in their netball skirts and light wind cheaters. Rachel and Sophie shivered almost in unison and wrapped their arms tightly around themselves. Cassie held her hands over her ears as a strong gust of wind swept over them all. Oh, my ears hurt when there's a cold wind. Daniel and Ben wandered along behind the girls, pushing their bikes. Ben, noticing Rachel and Sophie's discomfort, said, Hey, you two are starting to look like plucked chooks. Your legs have gone all white and goose pimply. Rachel screwed up her face at Ben, and Cassie giggled at him encouragingly while Sophie warned him with a shove of her shoulder, Watch it, or you'll lose your popcorn privileges. They paused at the front gate of the Mitchells' house. Strands of Rachel's dark wavy hair blew across her face as she looked at the house and thought of the comfortable familiarity inside. Sophie and Rachel attended different schools, but through netball they'd become close friends and spent every weekend together. Their friendship had started when Rachel and Sophie were selected to play in the regional representative side. They got on well immediately, and when Rachel found it difficult to get to the training nights, it was arranged that she should go to Sophie's house and get a ride to training from there. The more time Rachel had spent with Sophie and Daniel Mitchell, the more she liked them. This netball season, she had even changed clubs so that she could play with Sophie. Daniel, Sophie's brother, had recently become more than just a friend, so her weekends with the Mitchells had an added buzz. Rachel glanced at Daniel now. At 16, he was tall and athletic. Sophie was slighter with blonde hair, lighter than Daniel's, but they shared the same ready smile. Rachel enjoyed the noise and activity that always surrounded their large family. It provided a balance to the quieter home life she shared with her parents. Cassie's piping voice interrupted Rachel's thoughts. Well, I'll just go and get my overnight stuff, okay? See you all soon. She bounced off back in the direction they'd come, her blonde curls dancing around her shoulders. Sophie looked doubtfully at the figure retreating down the street. Does she realise we're having an early night, Rach? I suppose, Rachel responded tentatively, then added more confidently, she'd understand that, I'm sure. Ben waggled his eyebrows and grinned. I'm sure we can entertain her. He squared his shoulders and swaggered down the driveway, a skinny figure in baggy pants and an oversized hooded jacket. Laughing and shoving the ever-confident Ben, they headed into the house out of the cold wind. Just before they stepped in the back door, Daniel warned the others, Don't ask Mum about dinner when we go in. She's been really crabby lately. Your mum? Queried Rachel with disbelief. Yeah, added Sophie. All of a sudden, we have to do everything ourselves. Sophie and Daniel looked at each other and imitated their mother in unison. You can't rely on me to do everything for you. Ben and Rachel followed Daniel and Sophie's lead and slipped down the hallway, avoiding Mrs. Mitchell, who was in the kitchen. A
few hours later. We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.